FITO stands for Flexible ITO Solutions, and ITO is a material called indium tin oxide. It's a little bit geeky in terms, but indium tin oxide is a material that has these unique properties of being both transparent and conducts electricity. It's used for all the flat panel displays, all the photovoltaics, anything where you want to have light pass through it but still conduct electricity. I submitted a grant to the Ohio Third Frontier for $50,000. Got funding through the Third Frontier, which was their validation fund. So when you come up with a new technology, submit a patent, but you haven't made a prototype. So they gave me this money to see if I could make a prototype and if it was viable. I spent that first year just doing that. And at the end of the first year, we actually realized we could make relatively large films using this process and made a prototype switchable window that rolls up and rolls down. Typically in the past, the switchable windows are nothing new. There's a number of companies around the world that make them, and these windows typically switch from a scattering state to when you apply an electric field to a totally on state, so switching on and off. What FITOS allows you to do is, instead of just having a totally on and off, we can now make electrodes in the film, make it essentially like an electronic Venetian blind, add a lot of functionality to the material. I can change the width of my blinds, like rolling them up and rolling them down. So really adds a lot of potential to, or I can just have an individual line that rolls up and down. So it adds a lot of functionality at a very cheap price. This is the initial product we see for the FITOS technology. It's relatively straightforward. We see an easy way to get into the market. Once we've identified and gotten ourselves into market, I'd like to move on and see if we can use these films in touchscreens. So as touchscreens grow, everybody's familiar with being able to touch the screen of your cell phone. And now we're getting laptop computers, but this offers the potential of having very large touchscreens and much cheaper to make and fabricate. Also, as we move to flexible displays, so now your cell phone isn't this kind of solid, rigid device, becomes a flexible device. We hope to be making the substrates that make that possible. Particularly the Institute, the Liquid Crystal Institute, has been involved in this for 20 years. So there's been a whole series of spin-offs out of there. It has facilities that the startup companies can access and make use of that greatly simplify the starting process, just being able to make prototypes and have the facilities to do that. Also, one of the things we've learned in just starting up here is all the expertise at these various companies and how the environment is perfect here to set up a new company in this field.